Hi, my name is Jessica Kennedy, and I decided to do jail rehabilitation for my research topic. I chose this because I was just brainstorming topics. It just sounded interesting. I don't have any personal experience from it. I don't know anybody that has been to jail. I just have heard a lot of bad things about our jail system and decided to look further into that. When I was researching the topic, I wanted to originally research Spain. However, once I got further into that, I noticed that Spain actually has the worst jail system in Europe, and I wanted to research a country that was a lot different than America, because ours is the worst in the world when it comes to the amount of prisoners that are in our prisons. I wanted to find a low number amount of people that are in the prison in the country that I was going to research. And so while I was researching in Europe, I found Germany. And Germany, it was really interesting, the differences between them and our jail system. Up here is the definition of jail rehabilitation. It's the action of restoring someone to health or normal life through training and therapy after imprisonment. And I think America takes this definition literally because we have a lot of training and therapy. And I think that's the only type of jail rehabilitation that we actually have. Where Germany, their definition is different. They have the programs as well. So as I was doing my research, I found out that the programs aren't vastly different. We all go to class, they all go to classes, they all get taught by instructors, they have the free time to go to the gyms if they want. But the difference between America and Germany is the condition of their living conditions while they're in jail. I found out that in Germany, they can wear their own clothes in the jails. There are sometimes fully equipped kitchens in their jail system and prisons, some of the prisons, so they can cook their own food. There's knives and forks. They're not plastic, they're real, because they trust them enough to be able to cook their own food with the stove and everything. And Germany also has a lot of extra time and extra building space for when your family comes to visit you. You can visit your family for maybe once a week, once a month. Your whole family can come and spend the whole day, and the room is fully equipped with children's toys, books, and sometimes there are also other rooms for overnight stays for your wife or your husband, so you can have an overnight stay with your spouse. And in America, we don't have any of those. You are really lucky to even see your family. And if you get to see your family, the room is a blank room, like in here, with there's no posters, there's no warming atmosphere. There aren't really ever any tables or chairs. They just have to stand there, and they don't unshackle the prisoners. So it's almost actually embarrassing and demeaning when their families come and visit them. And that is where I went with my research paper, because the programs that I said before are around the same thing with the drugs, with the rehabilitation with drugs and the other crimes. It is evident that the only difference is the living conditions. And something that I thought was really interesting is how many of you, when you go through something, I don't want to say traumatic, but just you're going through something in life, like how many of you call a family member? Like raise your hands if you call a family member. And it's funny to me that in Germany they allow their prisoners to see their family, in America they don't. And it seems like that is one of the main, it just seems really important for someone going through something, they're trying to change their lives, that they would want to call their mom and talk to their mom if they're a child. Or, you know, they want to talk to their sons and daughters because they're growing up and they just can't. So I found that really confusing on America's end. And so I want to talk about the differences between them when it comes to how many prisoners we have and why they are actually better than us when it comes to the rehabilitation, like the facts. This is a chart. This red line is the United States, and this is how many prisoners we have in our jail. And this little line is Germany. This is per 100,000 people. So per 100,000 people in America, we have 700 people that are incarcerated. And in Germany, that number is 78. And That's a really big difference. We have 7 times more people in jail than Germany does, per capita. That's not talking about our population being different or anything. Per capita, we have 7 times more. And this is the number that we spend daily on a prisoner. So we spend $85 a day on a prisoner, and they spend $135 American dollars on a prisoner a day. And it seems like that money could be going to a lot of better things. Like Zach said earlier about the people that struggle with drugs going to jail, we spend, because we have so many prisoners, we spend so much more money on our prison system than these people could be out in the community doing something good. They could be doing other things rather than sitting in a cell doing nothing. These are 2 prison cells. One is America and one is Germany. This one here is really comfortable bed. They have a window they can look out. They have a really nice chair, actually similar to the chairs that you have here. And I think this is a bookshelf or like a shelf for your clothes, I'm not sure. And this might be a TV. It looks like a TV, but I'm not sure what that is. And the top one is significantly smaller. It has 2 desks, but the top one is not a desk because she can't use that as a desk, so I guess it's a shelf. And there are 2 beds, so they have to share this significantly smaller room. So this is obviously the Germany cell, and this is an American cell. The difference between these two is one is a right and one is a privilege. So this is what the majority of the people that get charged with a misdemeanor, they go to jail for 1 to 5 years. This is where a place where they would go. I Googled the best of the best photos. So these are the best of each country. So this is what they're coming out with now and what they look for. They look to change their jail system. This is Germany. And this is America. And this is actually a very privileged room because the government does not spend $85 a day on these people. This is a jail in California, and she is loaded. So instead of the government paying $85 a day for her, she pays $82 a day to be able to live in this jail cell. And it's called a pay and stay, so that's not normal. So it's funny to me that she has to go out of her way to get this kind of treatment, and it's not as good as what the Germans deem a human right, even though you're a criminal. And something that I thought was interesting is that in America, 90% of Americans, with a study that I found, think that we need more forgiveness in America as a country, as a nation, but 60% of the same people believe that there are some things that are unforgivable. And that's okay if things are unforgivable, maybe, but I don't believe that because you commit a crime, you're less of a human. And apparently Germans don't believe that either. They believe in the human right for everybody. And I don't know, maybe we don't, because I don't know, you have to do your business in front of everybody in an American cell, but in a German cell, you don't. You get your own restroom. So from that, I haven't done very many interviews. I want to interview a lady. She is a cop and she works in Marlington High School. And she said that she knows a lot about the jail rehabilitation here in our county jail. But other than the interviews I've done in this class, I haven't done any. And where I wanna go from now is, I did a lot of research on the history of America's jail cells or jail rehabilitation. And we have actually in the past taken away reading materials as a punishment. And solitary confinement is scientifically proven to drive you insane, and it's scientifically proven to diminish your growth, your mind growth, instead of grow it. And Germans are trying to get that out of the system, where we are just putting more people in solitary confinement currently. So I don't have any past, sources on the German jail cells and their rehabilitation and stuff like that. I only have currently what they're doing now. So that's where I would like to go from there. And that is all. Thank you.